Tree Drax because I knew Sharon Richardson. And she is one of the most amazing people I ever met. I wanted to know her secret to succeeding. Because while I was incarcerated, I was told I would never be a success. I was a troublemaker and very rebellious. I have the same history as being in prison as Sharon. And when I got ill, I had to sit down. And when I got bored, I started sewing buttons on my shirt. So just out of a joke that was in prison, I named my company Bummer's Buttons. As I listened to things that I learned from Sharon, I applied them to my business. I watched my company really grow on paper, on everything I put into it. And this class has been enough for me to show me that I'm still capable of accomplishing much, much more.
Good morning. My name is Laquita Brooks. I came to Reentry Rocks to become an entrepreneur and to further a new chapter in my life. I've learned to write a business plan and in the ins and outs of starting my own business one day for my next direction. I will take this journey that we call life and run with it. I am walking with confidence and a business mindset now and a plan with educational tools that I need and I've gained. I recommend this program to all women who have been impacted by the criminal justice system. I am humble. I am grateful for this opportunity. Thank you very much.
I joined Reentry Rocks to learn the basic aspect of starting a business as a new entrepreneur. I am grateful to have had this experience to join such a loving and beautiful group. Thank you for giving me this opportunity. I truly appreciate it. I didn't get a chance to graduate in person or do this in a class setting, but I think this virtual thing, we rocked it. We worked the hell out of it. And I just want to say thank you so much. And I appreciate it.
My name is Christine O'Mara. And I first learned about Reentry Rocks while I was on Rikers Island. I got so much from this class, it is truly amazing. I have a can-do attitude now and gaining more confidence. I will follow through and now see financial stability on the horizon. I am walking away with information, education about what it takes to start a business. What a great group of women and a wonderful organization.
I always wanted to find out who Sharon was. but thought it was a silly dream. How would I ever bounce back and find myself loving life again and having dreams of my own? I was an addict and a felon. I felt these dreams of me owning my own just fade like I did. But God answered my prayers and here I am today. I am clean and sober. Now my light has turned back on. Ladies, if I can come back from the depths of hell and fight my way up into my own apartment, enjoying life on my own terms with my children ever so close to me, and attending programs like Reentry Rocks and Excelling, you can achieve whatever dream you think of. Finally, I am free of the prison walls, free of the stigma that comes with being a junkie and a felon, free of the drugs forever, and free of the past that haunts me.
My name is Janice Lee. First, I want to thank God for being the head of my life. I stand here, well, actually, I sit here, a very proud Black woman of color, because never in my wildest dreams I would have thought I would be a valedictorian. It gives me such a great honor, and I'm very grateful. When I first was told about the Just So Catering program, I knew I had to do whatever I needed to do to get into that program, because food is my passion, and the love I have for food is so indescribable. I knew that once I was in, I would give it my all to succeed. I came in this class not knowing anything but the love of cooking and how I wanted to have my own business one day. For 8 weeks, I studied and I put my right foot in front of the other to keep moving forward in this process. I've gained so much knowledge and becoming an entrepreneur. I know that none of this would be possible without you guys, my classmates, my instructors, and the support and love that I receive from you all. I want you to know that I love you all and pray that we all continue on our journey of success. I also want to remind you, ladies, that we can do anything we set our minds out to. Keep up the good work and never give up on you, because you are the most important person. Love is love.
And Sharon, thank you so much for having me in your class.
And ladies, keep pressing on, because you all rock.
We rocked it. We worked the hell out of it.
You rock.
Ladies, we all rock with Reentry Rocks. Thank you for this opportunity. I am truly, truly grateful.
At the wall. I'm the founder and executive director of Reentry Rocks, a nonprofit 501c3 organization serving formerly incarcerated women, cis, trans, and gender expansive, particularly those with a history of
domestic violence throughout New York City.
We are the creative staff, board members, and participants of Reentry Rocks.
We together have strived to represent, be resilient, maintain strength.
Drive power, support, and courage.
We are the representation
of Rock by Rock,
tearing down struggle and pain, sorrow, separation, and desperation.
We are the representation of those who left their children,
family,
and loved ones.
It was at the wall our spirits climbed to seek freedom. Nights, morning, we cried, we wailed. She wept.
She cried.
They prayed, still praying. Then it happened, suddenly.
A pandemic. We all saw over 2 million people die.
At the wall.
Death and so much loss.
I can breathe.
Can you feel it? The cold concrete.
9 minutes and 29 seconds. Chaos. Uprising. The world became us. Unjust, unrest, anger, tears. We hoped, we prayed. Guilty.
It was at the wall that we
stood on the backs of our ancestors to look over to the other side. We saw the journey, remembered the pain, and paved the way.
A path that leads to this destination, cultivating a tapestry of love, sisterhood, movement, and joint efforts, togetherness as one, we are here.
Support Reentry Rocks.
Hey, peace and blessings, everyone. My name is Baba Obadiah Wright. I am a director, choreographer, producer, and master teacher. Sentenced to Dance was part of Reentry Rocks almost from the inception. Due to the pandemic, everything got shut down. So I am going to be the forerunner in reestablishing what this is and bringing a new edge to it, some new colors. So I'm very excited and motivated to get this movement piece back up and running, especially now coming from the pandemic, because everybody has been affected by this in one way or another. I'm going to be working to not just teach them choreography, but just to begin and go. We're going to do some of the psycho-spiritual healing as well. We're going to go into the body and work on some of the emotional things that have happened that impact the body and that they live in the body and live in the cells for years and years and years. Everyone needs to move, especially after you're talking about this particular group of human beings, these wonderful women, these beautiful spirits that I had the privilege to meet. They've been just locked down, for lack of a better word. So the sentencing is them beginning to work on their healing, is beginning to work on recalibrating their physical selves into their spiritual selves. And then that's going to help keep them prepared and sharp physically, mentally. So, and one of my goals is to get this to the national television level. I would love to see something like this be a docuseries, because the stories need to be told. So I really want you to think long and hard about how you're going to support Reentry Rocks, Sharon Richardson, and Sentence to Dance. God bless.
Hello, my name is Sharon Richardson. I'm the executive director of Reentry Rocks, a 501c3 nonprofit organization. This organization works directly with formerly incarcerated women, women who are returning home from prison. We are excited to say to you right now, stop everything that you're doing. It's important that you watch this video. It's important that you put down everything and focus your attention on this video. We were blessed by Angel Investor, our own space, 5 years rent free. But we have this open slab and we need your support. We have this wonderful space, this wonderful dance studio, our creative arts program, the internship program, and Sentence to Dance. And we need support making this happen, building the place out. And so this is where your money will go. And we want you to know more about Reentry Rocks. We want you to know more about who Sharon Richardson is and the program and the women and the participants that are going to be part of this program. And so this is the space, and we want you to view it. Stop everything that you're doing and watch this video. It's also important to share where your funding will go. There are three important positions that we need to hire for to scale Reentry Rocks. It's really, really hard to talk about, you know, how to make an organization grow. You need funding to be able to do that. And so we really, really need your support in doing that. Thank you.
My name is Sharon Richardson.
Reentry Rocks is a nonprofit organization, a 501c3, and it has a mission that works primarily with formerly incarcerated women, women who have gone through the criminal justice system, who have experienced domestic violence, who have gone through suffering and trauma, you know, who've been victims of such violence, so they themselves sometimes can't even speak about it. And so our programs at Reentry Rocks are very important, one of which is an internship program that lens to culinary and speaks about becoming an entrepreneur after incarceration. And then once going through that program, we have different phases. We have three phases, one of which where you learn to what it is to be an entrepreneur, get out of your own way, do a little bit of cooking, and then go into phase two and find out about the law and the taxes and everything, and then actually starting up your own business.
All the things you had to learn,
all
right?
Starting from scratch. Yes, yes. Yeah. And then we already know Sentence to Dance, you know, dancing through movement, telling your story through movement, healing and processing the hurt and the pain.
But if I recall correctly, you were dancing before you came home in prison.
Yes, yes. We started a whole dance group in the church. And we wrote plays. I wrote plays. We put them on for population. And yeah, it was just a way of bringing women to a place that they needed to be, that they didn't even know themselves that they could be at. You know, I'm in prison doing time, doing 15 years. I'm in prison doing time, I'm doing 10 years. I'm doing 5 years. I may never see the light of day. I'm doing 40 years. I'm doing 30 years. Mm-hmm. And here I am dancing. Here I am telling my story. Here I am moving my body in a way that helps me to feel good about myself and healing the onlookers.
Breathe in, breathe out, repeat after me. I am here.
To heal.
I am here.
I am here.
To become whole.
To become whole.
I am here.
I am here.
To step into my new self.
To step into my new self.
I am here.
I am here.
Because I am a product of my great and powerful ancestors.
Because I am a product of my great and powerful ancestors.
Who love me.
Who love me.
Who support me.
Who support me.
Who stand for me when I can't stand for myself.
Who stand for me when I can't stand for myself.
I am here.
I am here.
For my family.
For my family.
I am here.
I am here.
For all of the mothers that could not be here on this day, I am here.
For all of the mothers that could not be here on this day, I am here.
It's been a long 9 years.
equivalent to 9 months of carrying a child. Because I've been carrying this baby around for a long time. And we're finally here. Every door is opening. And when I think about the substance of Reentry Rocks and the mission and the population that we serve, I often ask myself and ask God, what have we done so great that you are blessing us the way you are? What have we done so great that every door that we knock on seems to open? And here we are. This all came about from a dream that I had one night. My close, long friend for over 100 years, just checking on him. Gave him a call. He was laid up in the hospital, about to lose his life. By right, he should have been dead. And my heart just wouldn't not help him. And through feeding him for 2 weeks, 3 weeks, we ended up having a conversation about me needing a choreographer. And he introduced me to this wonderful man named Baba Obadiah Wright. And the connection from that day set this whole thing on fire. You think COVID was bad? You think this last year was bad? Sentence to dance is bad. And we are moving into a space of no return. Reentry Rocks is bringing a creative arts program of healing, inspiration, transformation, bringing reentry to a place that no one has ever experienced. And I'm just in awe today.
Hi, Jen.
Hi, Jen. I'm learning how to heal myself spiritually, mentally, and physically. It's a lot of work right now for me, it being my first day and all, but I wouldn't have it any other way. I'm enjoying myself. I love the ladies that I'm involved with, the staff, the executive director, you, the cameraman, everybody has done a phenomenal job to welcome me and just show me mad love. So I'm good. I'm just a little tired, but I'm getting ready to take a dirty lavender chamomile bath when I get home. Because I'm sticky, I'm sweaty, but it's a good sweat. You know, I'm grateful that I have an opportunity to actually do something for me. And this right here is for me. Because it'll help me to heal some stuff that I have going on, you know, and
What would you say was the best part about working with Baba today?
Oh, Baba, hands down, I love him. You know, Baba is so, he has a spirit for me, just my opinion. His spirit is so phenomenal that, like, it's contagious. It's like a virus, but a good virus. You understand what I'm saying? Because he has an opportunity to pull things out of you that you don't believe that you have in yourself. Like today, like, you know, I suffered with anxieties and stuff like that, and I got overheated. I really didn't eat a lot of stuff, you know. And he took me in the bathroom, and he took energy from his body to give it to me, you know, and he showed me how to do that, you know. So it's not like this day has not been wasted at all. I have learned so much.
My name is Donna Patricia Charles. Today was wonderful for me. I'm just glad that I was accepted, because I always thought, coming from, you know, being incarcerated, that a lot of thing was not like extended to us. But meeting Sharon and a lot of other people, Rocky and you guys, has given me the opportunity to, you know, like, do something So I started cooking with Sharon, and then that led to a lot of other things, Reentry Rocks, teaching a class, and then now this dancing. And I said, I don't think I can do it, but I love to dance. So I showed up this morning bright and early, and it was wonderful. I just want to say thank you to everybody for including me, and the teacher for believing that, well, you know, we can. And I know dancing is going to help me because I've been through a lot.
Reentry Rocks believes that there's nothing you can't do, and is so glad that you are here.
I still go through that. I still believe that it's a lot I can't do. But with you guys, Rocky, Sharon, and the dancers, you know, you pull me out, and I appreciate that. And then today to come and be able to be among people that don't look at me for being incarcerated, just allow me to dance, and I'm just gonna dance. I might not get the steps, but my body and my spirit is just want to relieve whatever it is that I'm, you know, that's bottled up inside, because I need it. So thank you. I'm gonna do my best, and I'm gonna dance, and I'm gonna heal. I am. Thank you so much.
Excited for tomorrow?
I am. I'm gonna be here bright and early tomorrow with my porridge oatmeal, and I'm gonna dance. I'm gonna do my best. So keep including me, and don't shut me out. I'm gonna do my best, and I'm going to dance, and I am going to heal.
Thank you, Baba.
Thank you. Thank you, Sharon. Thank you, Baba. Thank you, all you camera guys. And thank you so much, and this is coming from my heart. Thank you very much for including me and accepting me and giving me the opportunity to heal, because I really, really need to heal. I do. So thank you.
Because I knew Sharon Richardson, and she is one of the most amazing people I ever met. I wanted to know her secret to succeeding, because while I was incarcerated, I was told I would never be a success. I was a troublemaker and very rebellious. I have the same history as being in prison as Sharon, and when I got ill, I had to sit down. And when I got bored, I started sewing buttons on my shirt. So just out of a joke that was in prison, I named my company Bummer's Button. As I listened to things that I learned from Sharon, I applied them to my business. I watched my company really grow on paper, on everything I put into it. And this class has been enough for me to show me that I'm still capable of accomplishing much, much more.
Good morning. My name is Laquita Brooks. I came to Reentry Rocks to become an entrepreneur and to further a new chapter in my life. I've learned to write a business plan and in the ins and outs of starting my own business one day for my next direction. I will take this journey that we call life and run with it. I am walking with confidence and a business mindset now, and a plan with educational tools that I need and I've gained. I recommend this program to all women who have been impacted by the criminal justice system. I am humble. I am grateful for this opportunity. Thank you very much.
I joined Reentry Rocks to learn the basic aspect of starting a business as a new entrepreneur. I am grateful to have had this experience to join such a loving and beautiful group. Thank you for giving me this opportunity. I truly appreciate it. I didn't get a chance to graduate in person or do this in a class setting, but I think this virtual thing, we rocked it. We worked the hell out of it. And I just want to say thank you so much. And I appreciate it.
name is Christine O'Mara, and I first learned about Reentry Rocks while I was on Rikers Island. I got so much from this class, it is truly amazing. I have a can-do attitude now and gaining more confidence. I will follow through and now see financial stability on the horizon. I am walking away with information, education about what it takes to start a business. What a great group of women and a wonderful organization.
I always wanted to find out who Sharon was, but thought it was a silly dream. How would I ever bounce back and find myself loving life again and having dreams of my own? I was an addict and a felon. I felt these dreams of me owning my own just fade like I did. But God answered my prayers, and here I am today. I am clean and sober. Now my light has turned back on. Ladies, if I can come back from the depths of hell and fight my way up into my own apartment, enjoying life on my own terms with my children ever so close to me, and attending programs like Reentry Rocks and Excelling, you can achieve whatever dream you think of. Finally, I am free of the prison walls, free of the stigma that comes with being a junkie and a felon, free of the drugs forever, and free of the past that haunts me.
My name is Janice Lee. First, I want to thank God for being the head of my life. I stand here, well, actually, I sit here, a very proud Black woman of color, because never in my wildest dreams I would have thought I would be a valedictorian. It gives me such a great honor, and I'm very grateful. When I first was told about the Just So Catering program, I knew I had to do whatever I needed to do to get into that program, because food is my passion, and the love I have for food is so indescribable. I knew that once I was in, I would give it my all to succeed. I came in this class not knowing anything but the love of cooking and how I wanted to have my own business one day. For 8 weeks, I studied and I put my right foot in front of the other to keep moving forward in this process. I've gained so much knowledge and becoming an entrepreneur. I know that none of this would be possible without you guys, my classmates, my instructors, and the support and love that I receive from you all. I want you to know that I love you all and pray that we all continue on our journey of success. I also want to remind you ladies that we can do anything we set our minds out to. Keep up the good work and never give up on you, because you are the most important person. Love is love.
And Sharon, thank you so much for having me in your class.
And ladies, keep pressing on, because you all rock.
We rocked it. We worked the hell out of it.
You rock.
Ladies, we all rock with Reentry Rocks. Thank you for this opportunity. I am truly, truly grateful.
At the wall.
I'm the founder and executive director of Reentry Rocks, a nonprofit 501c3 organization serving formerly incarcerated women, cis, trans, and gender expansive, particularly those with a history of
domestic violence throughout New York City.
We are the creative staff, board members, and participants of Reentry Rocks.
We together have strived to represent, be resilient, maintain strength, drive, power, support, and courage.
We are the representation
of Rock by Rock,
tearing down struggle and pain, sorrow, separation, and desperation.
We are the representation of those who left their children, family, and loved ones.
It was at the wall our spirits climbed to seek freedom. Nights, morning, we cried, we wailed. She wept.
She cried.
They prayed, still praying. Then it happened, suddenly.
A pandemic. We all saw over 2 million people die.
At the wall.
At the wall.
At the wall.
Death and so much loss.
I can breathe.
Can you feel it?
the cold concrete.
9 minutes and 29 seconds. Chaos, uprising, the world became us. Unjust, unrest, anger, tears. We hoped, we prayed. Guilty, guilty, guilty.
It was at the wall that we
stood on the backs of our ancestors to look over to the other side. We saw the journey, remembered the pain, and paved the way.
A path that leads to this destination, cultivating a tapestry of love, sisterhood, movement, and joint efforts, togetherness as one, we are here.
Support Reentry Rocks.
Hey, peace and blessings, everyone. My name is Baba Obadiah Wright. I am a director, choreographer, producer, and master teacher. Sentenced to Dance was part of Reentry Rocks almost from the inception. Due to the pandemic, everything got shut down. So I am going to be the forerunner in reestablishing what this is and bringing a new edge to it, some new colors. So I'm very excited and motivated to get this movement piece back up and running, especially now coming from the pandemic, because everybody has been affected by this in one way or another. I'm gonna be working to not just teach them choreography, but just to begin and go. We're gonna do some of the psycho-spiritual healing as well. We're gonna go into the body and work on some of the emotional things that have happened that impact the body and that they live in the body and live in the cells for years and years and years. Everyone needs to move, especially after you're talking about this particular group of human beings, these wonderful women, these beautiful spirits that I had the privilege to meet. They've been just locked down, for lack of a better word. So the sentencing is them beginning to work on their healing, is beginning to work on recalibrating their physical selves into their spiritual selves. And then that's going to help keep them prepared and sharp physically, mentally. So, and one of my goals is to get this to the national television level. I would love to see something like this be a docuseries because the stories need to be told. So I really want you to think long and hard about how you're going to support Reentry Rocks, Sharon Richardson, and Sentenced to Dance. God bless.
Hello, my name is Sharon Richardson. I'm the executive director of Reentry Rocks, a 501c3 nonprofit organization. This organization works directly with formerly incarcerated women, women who are returning home from prison. We are excited to say to you right now, stop everything that you're doing. It's important that you watch this video. It's important that you put down everything and focus your attention on this video. We were blessed by Angel Investor, our own space, 5 years rent free. But we have this open slab and we need your support. We have this wonderful space, this wonderful dance studio, our creative arts program, the internship program, and Sentenced to Dance. And we need support making this happen, building the place out. And so this is where your money will go. And we want you to know more about Reentry Rocks. We want you to know more about who Sharon Richardson is and the program and the women and the participants that are going to be part of this program. And so this is the space and we want you to view it. Stop everything that you're doing and watch this video. It's also important to share where your funding will go. There are three important positions that we need to hire for to scale Reentry Rocks. It's really, really hard to talk about, you know, how to make a organization grow. You need funding to be able to do that. And so we really, really need your support in doing that. Thank you.
My name is Sharon Richardson.
Reentry Rocks is a nonprofit organization, a 501c3, okay. And
that has a mission that works primarily with formerly incarcerated women, women who have gone through the criminal justice system, who have experienced domestic violence, who've gone through suffering and trauma, you know, who've been victims of such violence. So they themselves sometimes can't even speak about it. And so our programs at Reentry Rocks are very important, one of which is an internship program that lends to culinary and speaks about becoming an entrepreneur after incarceration. And then once going through that program, we have different phases. We have three phases, one of which where you learn to what it is to be an entrepreneur, get out of your own way, do a little bit of cooking, and then go into phase two and find out about the law and the taxes and everything, and then actually starting up your own business.
All the things you had to learn,
all
right?
Starting from scratch. Yes, yes. Yeah. And then we already know, sentence to dance, you know, dancing through movement, telling your story through movement, healing and processing the hurt and the pain.
But if I recall correctly, you were dancing before you came home in prison.
Yes, yes. We started a whole dance group in the church. And we wrote plays. I wrote plays. We put them on for population. And yeah, it was just a way of bringing women to a place that they needed to be, that they didn't even know themselves that they could be at. You know, I'm in prison doing time, doing 15 years. I'm in prison doing time, I'm doing 10 years. I'm doing 5 years. I may never see the light of day. I'm doing 40 years. I'm doing 30 years. Mm-hmm. And here I am dancing. Here I am telling my story. Here I am moving my body in a way that helps me to feel good about myself and healing the onlookers.
Breathe in, breathe out, repeat after me. I am here.
I am here.
To heal.
To heal.
I am here.
I am here.
To become whole.
To become whole.
I am here.
I am here.
To step into my new self.
To step into my new self.
I am here.
I am here.
Because I am a product of my great and powerful ancestors.
Because I am a product of my great and powerful ancestors.
Who love me.
Who love me.
Who support me.
Who support me.
Who stand for me when I can't stand for myself.
Who stand for me when I can't stand for myself.
I am here.
I am here.
For my family.
For my family.
I am here.
I am here.
For all of the mothers that could not be here on this day, I am here.
For all of the mothers that could not be here on this day, I am here.
It's been a long 9 years. Equivalent to 9 months of carrying a child, because I've been carrying this baby around for a long time. And we're finally here. Every door is opening. And when I think about the substance of Reentry Rocks and the mission and the population that we serve, I often ask myself and ask God, what have we done so great that you are blessing us the way you are? What have we done so great that every door that we knock on seems to open? And here we are. This all came about from a dream that I had one night. My close, long friend for over 100 years, just checking on him. Gave him a call. He was laid up in the hospital, about to lose his life. By right, he should have been dead. And my heart just wouldn't not help him. And through feeding him for 2 weeks, 3 weeks, we ended up having a conversation about me needing a choreographer. And he introduced me to this wonderful man named Baba Obadiah Wright. And the connection from that day set this whole thing on fire. You think COVID was bad? You think this last year was bad? Sentence to Dance is bad. And we are moving into a space of no return. Reentry Rocks is bringing a creative arts program of healing, inspiration, transformation, bringing reentry
to a place that no one has ever experienced. And I'm just in awe today.
Hi, Jan.
Hi, Jan. I'm learning how to heal myself spiritually, mentally, and physically. It's a lot of work right now for me, it being my first day and all, but I wouldn't have it any other way. I'm enjoying myself. I love the ladies that I'm involved with, the staff, the executive director, you, the cameraman, everybody has done a phenomenal job to welcome me and just show me mad love. So I'm good. I'm just a little tired, but I'm getting ready to take a dirty lavender chamomile bath when I get home. Because I'm sticky, I'm sweaty, but it's a good sweat. You know, I'm grateful that I have an opportunity to actually do something for me. And this right here is for me, because it'll help me to heal some stuff that I have going on, you know, and
what would you say was the best part about working with Baba today?
Oh, Baba, hands down, I love him. You know, Baba is so, he has a spirit for me, just my opinion. His spirit is so phenomenal that, like, it's contagious. It's like a virus, but a good virus. You understand what I'm saying? Because he has an opportunity to pull things out of you that you don't believe that you have in yourself. Like today, like, you know, I suffered with anxieties and stuff like that, and I got overheated. I really didn't eat a lot of stuff, you know. And he took me in the bathroom, and he took energy from his body to give it to me, you know, and he showed me how to do that, you know. So it's not like this day has not been wasted at all. I have learned so much.
My name is Donna Patricia Charles. Today was wonderful for me. I'm just glad that I was accepted, because I always thought, coming from, you know, being incarcerated, that a lot of things was not like extended to us. But meeting Sharon and a lot of other people, Rocky and you guys, has given me the opportunity to, you know, like do something. So I started cooking with Sharon, and then that led to a lot of other things, Reentry Rocks, teaching a class, and then now this dancing. And I said, I don't think I can do it, but I love to dance. So I showed up this morning bright and early, and it was wonderful. I just want to say thank you to everybody for including me, and the teacher for believing that, well, you know, we can. And I know dancing is going to help me, because I've been through a lot.
Reentry Rocks believes that there's nothing you can't do, and is so glad that you are here.
I still go through that. I still believe that it's a lot I can't do. But with you guys, Rocky, Sharon, and the dancers, you know, you pull me out, and I appreciate that. And then today to come and be able to be among people that don't look at me for being incarcerated, just allow me to dance, and I'm just gonna dance. I might not get the steps, but my body and my spirit is just want to relieve whatever it is that I'm, you know, that's bottled up inside, because I need it. So thank you, thank you, thank you. I'm gonna do my best, and I'm gonna dance, and I'm gonna heal. I am. Thank you so much.
Excited for tomorrow?
I am. I'm gonna be here bright and early tomorrow with my porridge oatmeal, and I'm gonna dance. I'm gonna do my best. So keep including me, and don't shut me out. I'm gonna do my best, and I'm going to dance, and I am going to heal.
Thank you, Donna.
Thank you. Thank you, Sharon. Thank you, Baba. Thank you, all you camera guys. And thank you so much, and this is coming from my heart. Thank you very much for including me and accepting me and giving me the opportunity to heal, because I really, really need to heal. I do. So thank you.
Yeah.
Reentry Rocks because I knew Sharon Richardson. And she is one of the most amazing people I ever met. I wanted to know her secret to succeeding. Because while I was incarcerated, I was told I would never be a success. I was a troublemaker and very rebellious. I have the same history as being in prison as Sharon. And when I got ill, I had to sit down. And when I got bored, I started sewing buttons on my shirt. So just out of a joke that was in prison, I named my company Bummer's Button. As I listened to things that I learned from Sharon, I applied them to my business. I watched my company really grow on paper, on everything I put into it. And this class has been enough for me to show me that I'm still capable of accomplishing much, much more.
Good morning, my name is Laquita Brooks. I came to Reentry Rocks to become an entrepreneur and to further a new chapter in my life. I've learned to write a business plan and in the ins and outs of starting my own business one day for my next direction. I will take this journey that we call life and run with it. I am walking with confidence and a business mindset now and a plan with educational tools that I need and I've gained. I recommend this program to all women who have been impacted by the criminal justice system. I am humble. I am grateful for this opportunity. Thank you very much.
I joined Reentry Rocks to learn the basic aspect of starting a business as a new entrepreneur. I am grateful to have had this experience to join such a loving and beautiful group. Thank you for giving me this opportunity. I truly appreciate it. I didn't get a chance to graduate in person or do this in a class setting, but I think this virtual thing, we rocked it. We worked the hell out of it. And I just want to say thank you so much. And I appreciate it.
My name is Christine O'Mara. And I first learned about Reentry Rocks while I was on Rikers Island. I got so much from this class, it is truly amazing. I have a can-do attitude now and gaining more confidence. I will follow through and now see financial stability on the horizon. I am walking away with information, education about what it takes to start a business. What a great group of women and a wonderful organization.
I always wanted to find out who Sharon was. But thought it was a silly dream. How would I ever bounce back and find myself loving life again and having dreams of my own? I was an addict and a felon. I felt these dreams of me owning my own just fade like I did. But God answered my prayers and here I am today. I am clean and sober. Now my light has turned back on. Ladies, if I can come back from the depths of hell and fight my way up into my own apartment, enjoying life on my own terms with my children ever so close to me, and attending programs like Reentry Rocks and Excelling, you can achieve whatever dream you think of. Finally, I am free of the prison walls, free of the stigma that comes with being a junkie and a felon, free of the drugs forever, and free of the past that haunts me.
My name is Janice Lee. First, I want to thank God for being the head of my life. I stand here, well, actually, I sit here, a very proud Black woman of color, because never in my wildest dreams I would have thought I would be a valedictorian. It gives me such a great honor, and I'm very grateful. When I first was told about the Just So Catering program, I knew I had to do whatever I needed to do to get into that program, because food is my passion, and the love I have for food is so indescribable. I knew that once I was in, I would give it my all to succeed. I came in this class not knowing anything but the love of cooking and how I wanted to have my own business one day. For 8 weeks, I studied and I put my right foot in front of the other to keep moving forward in this process. I've gained so much knowledge and becoming an entrepreneur. I know that none of this would be possible without you guys, my classmates, my instructors, and the support and love that I receive from you all. I want you to know that I love you all and pray that we all continue on our journey of success. I also want to remind you ladies that we can do anything we set our minds out to. Keep up the good work and never give up on you, because you are the most important person. Love is love.
And Sharon, thank you so much for having me in your class.
And ladies, keep pressing on, because you all rock.
We rocked it. We worked the hell out of it.
You rock.
Ladies, we all rock with Reentry Rocks. Thank you for this opportunity. I am truly, truly grateful.
At the wall.
At the wall.
At the wall.
I'm the founder and executive director of Reentry Rocks, a nonprofit 501c3 organization serving formerly incarcerated women, cis, trans, and gender expansive, particularly those with a history of
domestic violence throughout New York City.
We are the creative staff, board members and participants of Reentry Rocks.
We together have strived to represent, be resilient, maintain strength, drive power, support, and courage.
We are the representation
of Rock by Rock,
tearing down struggle and pain, sorrow, separation, and desperation.
We are the representation of those who left their children, family, and loved ones.
It was at the wall our spirits climbed to seek freedom. Nights, morning, we cried, we wailed. She wept.
She cried.
They prayed, still praying. Then it happened, suddenly.
A pandemic. We all saw over 2 million people die.
At the wall.
At the wall.
At the wall.
At the wall.
Death and so much loss.
I can breathe.
Can you feel it? The cold concrete.
9 minutes and 29 seconds. Chaos. Uprising. The world became us. Unjust, unrest, anger, tears. We hoped, we prayed. Guilty, guilty, guilty.
It was at the wall that we
stood on the backs of our ancestors to look over to the other side. We saw the journey, remembered the pain, and paved the way.
A path that leads to this destination, cultivating a tapestry of love, sisterhood, movement, and joint efforts. Togetherness as one, we are here.
Support Reentry Rocks.
Hey, peace and blessings, everyone. My name is Baba Obadiah Wright. I am a director, choreographer, producer, and master teacher. Sentenced to Dance was part of Reentry Rocks almost from the inception. Due to the pandemic, everything got shut down. So I am going to be the forerunner in reestablishing what this is and bringing a new edge to it, some new colors. So I'm very excited and motivated to get this movement piece back up and running, especially now coming from the pandemic, because everybody has been affected by this in one way or another. I'm going to be working to not just teach them choreography, but just to begin and go in and do some of the psycho-spiritual healing as well. We're going to go into the body and work on some of the emotional things that have happened that impact the body and that they live in the body and live in the cells for years and years and years. Everyone needs to move, especially after you're talking about this particular group of human beings, these wonderful women, these beautiful spirits that I had the privilege to meet. They've been just locked down, for lack of a better word. So the sentencing is them beginning to work on their healing, is beginning to work on recalibrating their physical selves into their spiritual selves. And then that's going to help keep them prepared and sharp physically, mentally. So, and one of my goals is to get this to the national television level. I would love to see something like this be a docuseries, because the stories need to be told. So I really want you to think long and hard about how you're going to support Reentry Rocks, Sharon Richardson, and Senses to Dance. God bless.
Hello, my name is Sharon Richardson. I'm the executive director of Reentry Rocks, a 501c3 nonprofit organization. This organization works directly with formerly incarcerated women, women who are returning home from prison. We are excited to say to you right now, stop everything that you're doing. It's important that you watch this video. It's important that you put down everything and focus your attention on this video. We were blessed by Angel Investor, our own space, 5 years rent-free. But we have this open slab and we need your support. We have this wonderful space, this wonderful dance studio, our creative arts program, the internship program, and Sentence to Dance. And we need support making this happen, building the place out. And so this is where your money will go. And we want you to know more about Reentry Rocks. We want you to know more about who Sharon Richardson is and the program and the women and the participants that are going to be part of this program. And so this is the space, and we want you to view it. Stop everything that you're doing and watch this video. It's also important to share where your funding will go. There are three important positions that we need to hire for to scale Reentry Rocks. It's really, really hard to talk about, you know, how to make an organization grow. You need funding to be able to do that. And so we really, really need your support in doing that. Thank you.
My name is Sharon Richardson.
Reentry Rocks is a nonprofit organization, a 501c3, and it has a mission that works primarily with formerly incarcerated women, women who have gone through the criminal justice system, who've experienced domestic violence, who've gone through suffering and trauma, you know, who've been victims of such violence, so they themselves sometimes can't even speak about it. And so our programs at Reentry Rocks are very important, one of which is an internship program that lends to culinary and speaks about becoming an entrepreneur after incarceration. And then once going through that program, we have different phases. We have three phases, one of which where you learn to what it is to be an entrepreneur, get out of your own way, do a little bit of cooking, and then go into phase two and find out about the law and the taxes and everything, and then actually starting up your own business.
All the things you had to learn,
all
right?
Starting from scratch. Yes, yes. Yeah. And then we already know Sentence to Dance, you know, dancing through movement, telling your story through movement, healing and processing the hurt and the pain.
But if I recall correctly, you were dancing before you came home in
yes,
prison.
Yes, yes. We started a whole dance group in the church. And we wrote plays. I wrote plays. We put them on for population. And yeah, it was just a way of bringing women to a place that they needed to be, that they didn't even know themselves that they could be at. You know, I'm in prison doing time, doing 15 years. I'm in prison doing time, I'm doing 10 years. I'm doing 5 years. I may never see the light of day. I'm doing 40 years. I'm doing 30 years. Mm-hmm. And here I am dancing. Here I am telling my story. Here I am moving my body in a way that helps me to feel good about myself and healing the onlookers.
Breathe in, breathe out, repeat after me. I am here.
I am here.
To heal.
To heal.
I am here.
I am here.
To become whole.
To become whole.
I am here.
I am here.
To step into my new self.
To step into my new self.
I am here.
I am here.
Because I am a product of my great and powerful ancestors.
Because I am a product of my great and powerful ancestors.
Who love me.
Who love me.
Who support me.
Who support me.
Who stand for me when I can't stand for myself.
Who stand for me when I can't stand for myself.
I am here.
I am here.
For my family.
For my family.
I am here.
I am here.
For all of the
mothers that could not be here on this day, I am here.
For all of the mothers that could not be here on this day, I am here.
It's been a long 9 years. Equivalent to 9 months of carrying a child. Because I've been carrying this baby around for a long time. And we're finally here. Every door is opening. And when I think about the substance of Reentry Rocks and the mission and the population that we serve, I often ask myself and ask God, what have we done so great that you are blessing us the way you are? What have we done so great that every door that we knock on seems to open? And here we are. This all came about from a dream that I had one night. My close, long friend for over 100 years, just checking on him. Gave him a call. He was laid up in the hospital, about to lose his life. By right, he should have been dead. And my heart just wouldn't not help him. And through feeding him for 2 weeks, 3 weeks, we ended up having a conversation about me needing a choreographer. And he introduced me to this wonderful man named Baba Obadiah Wright. And the connection from that day set this whole thing on fire. You think COVID was bad? You think this last year was bad? Sentence to Dance is bad. And we are moving into a space of no return. Reentry Rocks is bringing a creative arts program of healing, inspiration, transformation, bringing reentry to a place that no one has ever experienced. And I'm just in awe today.
Hi, Jan.
Hi, Jan. I'm learning how to heal myself spiritually, mentally, and physically. It's a lot of work right now for me, it being my first day and all, but I wouldn't have it any other way. I'm enjoying myself. I love the ladies that I'm involved with, the staff, the executive director, you, the cameraman, everybody. Everybody has done a phenomenal job to welcome me and just show me mad love. So I'm good. I'm just a little tired, but I'm getting ready to take a dirty, dirty, dirty lavender chamomile bath when I get home. Because I'm sticky, I'm sweaty, but it's a good sweat. You know, I'm grateful that I have an opportunity to actually do something for me. And this right here is for me. Because it'll help me to heal some stuff that I have going on, you know, and
what would you say was the best part about working with Baba today?
Oh, Baba, hands down, I love him. You know, Baba is so, he has a spirit for me, just my opinion. His spirit is so phenomenal that, like, it's contagious. It's like a virus, but a good virus. You understand what I'm saying? Because he has an opportunity to pull things out of you that you don't believe that you have in yourself. Like today, like, you know, I suffer with anxieties and stuff like that, and I got overheated. I really didn't eat a lot of stuff, you know. And he took me in the bathroom, and he took energy from his body to give it to me, you know, and he showed me how to do that, you know. So it's not like this day has not been wasted at all. I have learned so much.
My name is Donna Patricia Charles. Today was wonderful for me. I'm just glad that I was accepted, because I always thought, coming from, you know, being incarcerated, that a lot of things was not like extended to us. But meeting Sharon and a lot of other people, Rocky and you guys, has given me the opportunity to, you know, like, do something. So I started cooking with Sharon, and then that led to a lot of other things, Reentry Rocks, teaching a class, and then now this dancing. And I said, I don't think I can do it, but I love to dance. So I showed up this morning bright and early, and it was wonderful. I just want to say thank you to everybody for including me, and the teacher for believing that, well, you know, we can. And I know dancing is going to help me because I've been through a lot.
Reentry Rocks believes that there's nothing you can't do, and is so glad that you are here.
I still go through that. I still believe that it's a lot I can't do. But with you guys, Rocky, Sharon, and the dancers, you know, you pull me out, and I appreciate that. And then today to come and be able to be among people that don't look at me for being incarcerated, just allow me to dance, and I'm just going to dance. I might not get the steps, but my body and my spirit is just want to relieve whatever it is that I'm, you know, that's bottled up inside, because I need it. So thank you, thank you, thank you. I'm gonna do my best, and I'm gonna dance, and I'm gonna heal. I am. Thank you so much.
Excited for tomorrow?
I am. I'm gonna be here bright and early tomorrow with my porridge oatmeal, and I'm gonna dance. I'm gonna do my best. So keep including me, and don't shut me out. I'm gonna do my best, and I'm going to dance, and I am going to heal.
Thank you, Donna.
Thank you. Thank you, Sharon. Thank you, Baba. Thank you, all you camera guys. And thank you so much, and this is coming from my heart. Thank you very much for including me and accepting me and giving me the opportunity to heal, because I really, really need to heal. I do. So thank you.
Rocks, because I knew Sharon Richardson, and she is one of the most amazing people I ever met. I wanted to know her secret to succeeding, because while I was incarcerated, I was told I would never be a success. I was a troublemaker and very rebellious. I have the same history as being in prison as Sharon, and when I got ill, I had to sit down. And when I got bored, I started sewing buttons on my shirt. So just out of a joke that was in prison, I named my company Bummer's Button. As I listened to things that I learned from Sharon, I applied them to my business. I watched my company really grow on paper, on everything I put into it. And this class has been enough to me to show me that I'm still capable of accomplishing much, much more.
Good morning. My name is Laquita Brooks. I came to Reentry Rocks to become an entrepreneur and to further a new chapter in my life. I've learned to write a business plan and in the ins and outs of starting my own business one day for my next direction. I will take this journey that we call life and run with it. I am walking with confidence and a business mindset now, and a plan with educational tools that I need and I've gained. I recommend this program to all women who have been impacted by the criminal justice system. I am humble. I am grateful for this opportunity. Thank you very much.
I joined Reentry Rocks to learn the basic aspect of starting a business as a new entrepreneur. I am grateful to have had this experience to join such a loving and beautiful group. Thank you for giving me this opportunity. I truly appreciate it. I didn't get a chance to graduate in person or do this in a class setting, but I think this virtual thing, we rocked it. We worked the hell out of it. And I just want to say thank you so much. And I appreciate it.
My name is Christine O'Mara. And I first learned about Reentry Rocks while I was on Rikers Island. I got so much from this class, it is truly amazing. I have a can-do attitude now and gaining more confidence. I will follow through and now see financial stability on the horizon. I am walking away with information, education about what it takes to start a business. What a great group of women and a wonderful organization.
I always wanted to find out who Sharon was, but thought it was a silly dream. How would I ever bounce back and find myself loving life again and having dreams of my own? I was an addict and a felon. I felt these dreams of me owning my own just fade like I did. But God answered my prayers and here I am today. I am clean and sober. Now my light has turned back on. Ladies, if I can come back from the depths of hell and fight my way up into my own apartment, enjoying life on my own terms with my children ever so close to me, and attending programs like Reentry Rocks and Excelling, you can achieve whatever dream you think of. Finally, I am free of the prison walls, free of the stigma that comes with being a junkie and a felon, free of the drugs forever, and free of the past that haunts me.
My name is Janice Lee. First, I want to thank God for being the head of my life. I stand here, well, actually, I sit here, a very proud Black woman of color, because never in my wildest dreams I would have thought I would be a valedictorian. It gives me such a great honor, and I'm very grateful. When I first was told about the Just So Catering program, I knew I had to do whatever I needed to do to get into that program. Because food is my passion, and the love I have for food is so indescribable. I knew that once I was in, I would give it my all to succeed. I came in this class not knowing anything but the love of cooking and how I wanted to have my own business one day. For 8 weeks, I studied and I put my right foot in front of the other to keep moving forward in this process. I've gained so much knowledge and becoming an entrepreneur. I know that none of this would be possible without you guys, my classmates, my instructors, and the support and love that I receive from you all. I want you to know that I love you all and pray that we all continue on our journey of success. I also want to remind you ladies that we can do anything we set our minds out to. Keep up the good work and never give up on you because you're the most important person. Love is love.
And Sharon, thank you so much for having me in your class.
And ladies, keep pressing on because you all rock.
We rocked it. We worked the hell out of it.
You rock.
Ladies, we all rock with Reentry Rocks. Thank you for this opportunity. I am truly, truly grateful.
At the wall.
At the wall.
At the wall.
I'm the founder and executive director of Reentry Rocks, a nonprofit 501c3 organization serving formerly incarcerated women, cis, trans, and gender expansive, particularly those with a history of
domestic violence throughout New York City.
We are the creative staff, board members, and participants of Reentry Rocks.
We together have strived to represent, be resilient,
maintain strength,
drive power,
support, and courage.
We are the representation
of Rock by Rock,
tearing down struggle and pain, sorrow, separation, and desperation.
We are the representation of those who left their children,
family,
and loved ones.
It was at the wall our spirits climbed to seek freedom. Nights, morning, we cried, we wailed. She wept.
She cried.
They prayed, still praying. Then it happened suddenly.
A pandemic. We all saw over 2 million people die.
At the wall.
Death. And so much loss.
I can't breathe.
Can you feel it? The cold concrete.
9 minutes and 29 seconds. Chaos. Uprising. The world became us. Unjust. Unrest. Anger. Tears. We hoped. We prayed. Guilty. Guilty. Guilty.
It was at the wall that we
stood on the backs of our ancestors to look over to the other side. We saw the journey, remembered the pain, and paved the way.
A path that leads to this destination, cultivating a tapestry of love, sisterhood, movement, and joint efforts, togetherness as one, we are here.
Support Reentry Rocks.
Hey, peace and blessings, everyone. My name is Baba Obadiah Wright. I am a director, choreographer, producer, and master teacher. Sentenced to Dance was part of Reentry Rocks almost from the inception. Due to the pandemic, everything got shut down. So I am going to be the forerunner in reestablishing what this is and bringing a new edge to it, some new colors. So I'm very excited and motivated to get this movement piece back up and running, especially now coming from the pandemic, because everybody has been affected by this in one way or another. I'm going to be working to not just teach them choreography, but just to begin and go and do some of the psycho-spiritual healing as well. We're going to go into the body and work on some of the emotional things that have happened that impact the body and that they live in the body and live in the cells for years and years and years. Everyone needs to move, especially after you're talking about this particular group of human beings, these wonderful women, these beautiful spirits that I had the privilege to meet. They've been just locked down, for lack of a better word. So the sentencing is them beginning to work on their healing, is beginning to work on recalibrating their physical selves into their spiritual selves. And then that's going to help keep them prepared and sharp physically, mentally. So, and one of my goals is to get this to the national television level. I would love to see something like this be a docuseries, because the stories need to be told. So I really want you to think long and hard about how you're going to support Reentry Rocks, Sharon Richardson, and Sentenced to Dance. God bless.
Hello, my name is Sharon Richardson. I'm the executive director of Reentry Rocks, a 501c3 nonprofit organization. This organization works directly with formerly incarcerated women, women who are returning home from prison. We are excited to say to you right now, stop everything that you're doing. It's important that you watch this video. It's important that you put down everything and focus your attention on this video. We were blessed by Angel Investor, our own space, 5 years rent free. But we have this open slab and we need your support. We have this wonderful space, this wonderful dance studio, our creative arts program, the internship program, and Sentenced to Dance. And we need support making this happen, building the place out. And so this is where your money will go. And we want you to know more about Reentry Rocks. We want you to know more about who Sharon Richardson is and the program and the women and the participants that are going to be part of this program. And so this is the space, and we want you to view it. Stop everything that you're doing and watch this video. It's also important to share where your funding will go. There are three important positions that we need to hire for to scale Reentry Rocks. It's really, really hard to talk about, you know, how to make a organization grow. You need funding to be able to do that. And so we really, really need your support in doing that. Thank you.
My name is Sharon Richardson.
Reentry Rocks is a nonprofit organization, a 501c3, and it has a mission that works primarily with formerly incarcerated women, women who have gone through the criminal justice system, who've experienced domestic violence, who've gone through suffering and trauma, you know, who've been victims of such violence, so they themselves sometimes can't even speak about it. And so our programs at Reentry Rocks are very important, one of which is an internship program that lends to culinary and speaks about becoming an entrepreneur after incarceration. And then once going through that program, we have different phases. We have three phases, one of which where you learn to what it is to be an entrepreneur, get out of your own way, do a little bit of cooking, and then go into phase two and find out about the law and the taxes and everything, and then actually starting up your own business.
All the things you had to learn,
all
right?
Starting from scratch. Yes, yes. Yeah. And then we already know, sentence to dance, you know, dancing through movement, telling your story through movement, healing and processing the hurt and the pain.
But if I recall correctly, you were dancing before you came home in prison.
Yes, yes. We started a whole dance group in the church. And we wrote plays. I wrote plays. We put them on for population. And yeah, it was just a way of bringing women to a place that they needed to be, that they didn't even know themselves that they could be at. You know, I'm in prison doing time, doing 15 years. I'm in prison doing time, I'm doing 10 years. I'm doing 5 years. I may never see the light of day. I'm doing 40 years. I'm doing 30 years. Mm-hmm. And here I am dancing. Here I am telling my story. Here I am moving my body in a way that helps me to feel good about myself and healing the onlookers.
Breathe in, breathe out, repeat after me. I am here.
I am here.
To heal.
To heal.
I am here.
I am here.
To become whole.
To become whole.
I am here.
I am here.
To step into my new self.
To step into my new self.
I am here.
I am here.
Because I am a product of my great and powerful ancestors.
Because I am a product of my great and powerful ancestors.
Who love me.
Who love me.
Who support me.
Who support me.
Who stand for me when I can't stand for myself.
Who stand for me when I can't stand for myself.
I am here.
I am here.
For my family.
For my family.
I am here.
I am here.
For all of the mothers that could not be here on this day, I am here.
For all of the mothers that could not be here on this day, I am here.
It's been a long 9 years. Equivalent to 9 months of carrying a child, because I've been carrying this baby around for a long time. And we're finally here. Every door is opening. And when I think about the substance of Reentry Rocks and the mission and the population that we serve, I often ask myself and ask God, what have we done so great that you are blessing us the way you are? What have we done so great that every door that we knock on seems to open? And here we are. This all came about from a dream that I had one night. My close, long friend for over 100 years, just checking on him. Gave him a call. He was laid up in the hospital, about to lose his life. By right, he should have been dead. And my heart just wouldn't not help him. And through feeding him for 2 weeks, 3 weeks, we ended up having a conversation about me needing a choreographer. And he introduced me to this wonderful man named Baba Obadiah Wright. And the connection from that day set this whole thing on fire. You think COVID was bad? You think this last year was bad? Sentence to Dance is bad. And we are moving into a space of no return. Reentry Rocks is bringing a creative arts program of healing
inspiration, transformation, bringing reentry to a place that no one has ever experienced. And I'm just in awe today.
Hi, Jen.
Hi, Jen. I'm learning how to heal myself spiritually, mentally, and physically. It's a lot of work right now for me, it being my first day and all, but I wouldn't have it any other way. I'm enjoying myself. I love the ladies that I'm involved with, the staff, the executive director, you, the cameraman, everybody. Everybody has done a phenomenal job to welcome me and just show me mad love. So I'm good. I'm just a little tired, but I'm getting ready to take a dirty lavender chamomile bath when I get home. Because I'm sticky, I'm sweaty, but it's a good sweat. You know, I'm grateful that I have an opportunity to actually do something for me. And this right here is for me, because it'll help me to heal some stuff that I have going on, you know, and
what would you say was the best part about working with Baba today?
Oh, Baba, hands down, I love him. You know, Baba is so, he has a spirit for me, just my opinion. His spirit is so phenomenal that, like, it's contagious. It's like a virus, but a good virus. You understand what I'm saying? Because he has an opportunity to pull things out of you that you don't believe that you have in yourself. Like today, like, you know, I suffer with anxieties and stuff like that, and I got overheated. I really didn't eat a lot of stuff, you know. And he took me in the bathroom, and he took energy from his body to give it to me, you know, and he showed me how to do that, you know. So it's not like this day has not been wasted at all. I have learned so much.
My name is Donna Patricia Charles. Today was wonderful for me. I'm just glad that I was accepted, because I always thought, coming from, you know, being incarcerated, that a lot of things was not like extended to us. But meeting Sharon and a lot of other people, Rocky and you guys, has given me the opportunity to, you know, like, do something. So I started cooking with Sharon, and then that led to a lot of other things, Reentry Rocks, teaching a class, and then now this dancing. And I said, I don't think I can do it, but I love to dance. So I showed up this morning bright and early, and it was wonderful. I just want to say thank you to everybody for including me, and the teacher for believing that, well, you know, we can. And I know dancing is going to help me, because I've been through a lot.
Reentry Rocks believes that there's nothing you can't do, and is so glad that you are here.
I still go through that. I still believe that it's a lot I can do. But with you guys, Rocky, Sharon, and the dancers, you know, you pulled me out, and I appreciate that. And then today to come and be able to be among people that don't look at me for being incarcerated, just allow me to dance, and I'm just gonna dance. I might not get the steps, but my body and my spirit is just want to relieve whatever it is that I'm, you know, that's bottled up inside, because I need it. So thank you, thank you, thank you. I'm gonna do my best, and I'm gonna dance, and I'm gonna heal. I am. Thank you so
much. Excited for tomorrow?
I am. I'm gonna be here bright and early tomorrow with my porridge oatmeal, and I'm gonna dance. I'm gonna do my best. So keep including me, and don't shut me out. I'm gonna do my best, and I'm going to dance, and I am going to heal.
Thank you, Baba.
Thank you. Thank you, Sharon. Thank you, Baba. Thank you, all you camera guys. And thank you so much, and this is coming from my heart. Thank you very much for including me and accepting me and giving me the opportunity to heal, because I really, really need to heal. I do. So thank you.
Rocks because I knew Sharon Richardson. And she is one of the most amazing people I ever met. I wanted to know her secret to succeeding. Because while I was incarcerated, I was told I would never be a success. I was a troublemaker and very rebellious. I have the same history as being in prison as Sharon. And when I got ill, I had to sit down. And when I got bored, I started sewing buttons on my shirt. So just out of a joke that was in prison, I named my company Bummer's Buttons. As I listened to things that I learned from Sharon, I applied them to my business. I watched my company really grow on paper, on everything I put into it. And this class has been enough for me to show me that I'm still capable of accomplishing much, much more.
Good morning. My name is Laquita Brooks. I came to Reentry Rocks to become an entrepreneur and to further a new chapter in my life. I've learned to write a business plan and in the ins and outs of starting my own business one day for my next direction. I will take this journey that we call life and run with it. I am walking with confidence and a business mindset now and a plan with educational tools that I need and I've gained. I recommend this program to all women who have been impacted by the criminal justice system. I am humble. I am grateful for this opportunity. Thank you very much.
I joined Reentry Rocks to learn the basic aspect of starting a business as a new entrepreneur. I am grateful to have had this experience to join such a loving and beautiful group. Thank you for giving me this opportunity. I truly appreciate it. I didn't get a chance to graduate in person or do this in a class setting, but I think this virtual thing, we rocked it. We worked the hell out of it. And I just want to say thank you so much. And I appreciate it.
My name is Christine O'Mara. And I first learned about Reentry Rocks while I was on Rikers Island. I got so much from this class, it is truly amazing. I have a can-do attitude now and gaining more confidence. I will follow through and now see financial stability on the horizon. I am walking away with information, education about what it takes to start a business. What a great group of women and a wonderful organization.
I always wanted to find out who Sharon was. But thought it was a silly dream. How would I ever bounce back and find myself loving life again and having dreams of my own? I was an addict and a felon. I felt these dreams of me owning my own just fade like I did. But God answered my prayers and here I am today. I am clean and sober. Now my light has turned back on. Ladies, if I can come back from the depths of hell and fight my way up into my own apartment, enjoying life on my own terms with my children ever so close to me, and ending programs like Reentry Rocks and Excelling, you can achieve whatever dream you think of. Finally, I am free of the prison walls, free of the stigma that comes with being a junkie and a felon, free of the drugs forever, and free of the past that haunts me.
My name is Janice Lee. First, I want to thank God for being the head of my life. I stand here, I sit here, a very proud Black woman of color, because never in my wildest dreams I would have thought I would be a valedictorian. It gives me such a great honor, and I'm very grateful. When I first was told about the Just So Catering program, I knew I had to do whatever I needed to do to get into that program, because food is my passion, and the love I have for food is so indescribable. I knew that once I was in, I would give it my all to succeed. I came in this class not knowing anything but the love of cooking and how I wanted to have my own business one day. For 8 weeks, I studied and I put my right foot in front of the other to keep moving forward in this process. I've gained so much knowledge and becoming an entrepreneur. I know that none of this would be possible without you guys, my classmates, my instructors, and the support and love that I receive from you all. I want you to know that I love you all and pray that we all continue on our journey of success. I also want to remind you ladies that we can do anything we set our minds out to. Keep up the good work and never